Welcome. In this video, we are going to see about atoms and molecules. First, let's see how to calculate average atomic mass. Average atomic mass of an element is the weighted average of the masses of its naturally occurring isotopes. Let's see with an example. If an element has the atomic number of 5 and it has two isotopes in nature, first isotope has the atomic mass of each isotope is abundant 50% in nature. In other words, to make it simple, we can say it as in 100 grams of the element X, 50 grams of X10 and 50 grams of X11 will be abundant. 50 grams of X10. Okay, so now we are going to see how to calculate the average atomic mass for the element X. So average atomic mass can be calculated by using this formula. The mass of first isotope should be multiplied with percentage abundance of that particular isotope. Should be multiplied with percentage abundance. This should be added with the mass of second isotope into percentage abundance of that second isotope, percentage abundance of that particular isotope. So by substituting the values, we will get the atomic average atomic mass of the element X. So in the first isotope, the mass is 10 and the percentage abundance is 50. 50 should be divided by 100 because we are converting percentage into number, and this should be added with the mass of second isotope is 11. 11 into 50 divided by 100 because that isotope also abundant 50% in nature. By simplifying these values, we will get 5 ones of 5 plus 1.1 into 5, which is equal to 5.5. So total the value, we will get 10.5. So 10.5 is the average atomic mass of that particular element, that is X. This is how we need to calculate the average atomic mass for each and every elements. Next example, we are going to calculate the average atomic mass for carbon. Carbon also has two isotopes in nature. They are carbon 12 and carbon 13. Now we are going to see how to calculate average atomic mass. Carbon 12 is abundant in nature in 98.9%. And carbon 13, 1.1% is the percentage abundance of that element. It means in 100 grams of carbon, 98.9 grams of carbon 12 and 1.1 gram of carbon 13 will be presented. So the same formula only, we need to substitute the values. So mass of first element, mass of first element, which is 12 into 98.9 divided by 100 because we are converting percentage into number, that's why we need to divide by 100, plus 13. 13 is the mass of second isotope into 1.1 divided by 100. By simplifying these values, 12 into 0.989 plus 13 into 0.011. By simplifying, we will get 11.868 plus 0.143. Total these two values, which is equal to 12.011 atomic mass units. So this is how we need to calculate the average atomic mass of carbon. Next, we are going to see about molecules. Molecules are the combination of two or more atoms, and those atoms will be strongly held together because of some strong chemical forces, and those chemical forces are called as chemical bonds. So chemical bonds are the reason behind the formation of molecules. So now we are going to see what are the two types of molecules. Molecules are divided or classified into two types. They are homoatomic and heteroatomic. So let's see the examples first, and afterwards we'll see the definition. So hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, ozone, iodine. These are the some examples for homoatomic as well as for heteroatomic. Water, carbon dioxide, and these are the examples of heteroatomic. So homoatomic in the sense same elements will be presented in that molecule. Heteroatomic in the sense different elements will be presented in that molecule. In carbon dioxide, there are two types of elements. They are carbon and oxygen. In water also, there are two types of elements. They are hydrogen and oxygen. Based on the types of entities, we are dividing molecules into two types. They are homoatomic and heteroatomic. We have seen how molecules are classified into two types based on the type of elements presented. Next, we are going to see another type of classification based on the number of elements presented in that. So based on the number of elements, molecules are classified into three types. They are diatomic, triatomic, and polyatomic. So first, let's see the examples. After that, we'll see the definition. First, for diatomic, oxygen, iodine, nitrogen. These are the some examples of homoatomic molecules. As well as in heteroatomic, Hi and HCl. In all these five molecules, you can see that only there are two elements. Due to that only, they are called as diatomic molecules. And first three molecules are homodiatomic because there is only one type of element in those three molecules. As well as these two are called as heterodiatomic because in that molecules there are only two elements, as well as they are different types to each other. As well as for triatomic, ozone, that is O3 and H2O, carbon dioxide. See, look at these molecules, there are only three elements, as well as the first ozone is called as homotriatomic because there is only one type of element in that molecule. As well as H2O and CO2 are the examples for heterotriatomic because there are different type of elements, as well as there are only three elements. Okay, for polyatomic, so more than three elements, in whichever molecules more than three elements are presented, they are called as polyatomic. They are hetero. Okay, so first HTSO4 is the example for heteropolyatomic, as well as phosphorus and sulfur are the examples for homopolyatomic. So these are the three types of molecules based on the number of elements presented. If there are two elements, they are called as diatomic, three elements triatomic. If more than three elements are presented in a molecule, they are called as polyatomic. Next, we are going to see how to calculate relative molecular mass. So relative molecular mass is the ratio between the mass of one molecule of the substance to 1/12th mass of an atom of carbon 12. To make it simple, we can say that to calculate relative molecular mass of a molecule, we need to add the average atomic mass of individual atoms presented in that. So by adding average atomic mass of individual atoms in a molecule, we can find out the relative molecular mass. Let's see with an example. First, we are going to calculate the relative molecular mass for H2O, that is for water. So in water, there are two types of elements. They are hydrogen and oxygen. and there are two hydrogen atoms, one oxygen atom, totally there are three atoms. So relative molecular mass of H2O is equal to 2 into average atomic mass of hydrogen plus 1 into average atomic mass of oxygen. Okay, so this is how we need to calculate the relative molecular mass of water. So 2 into 1.008 plus 1 into 16. So by simplifying, we will get 2.016 plus 2.016 plus 16, which is equal to 18.016. So 18.016 is the relative molecular mass of water. So this is how we need to calculate the average, relative molecular mass for each and every molecules. Next, let's see another example. So now we are going to calculate the relative molecular mass for H2SO4, that is for sulfuric acid. So same method. First, we need to calculate, we need to find out what are the elements and how many of them are presented. So in H2SO4, there are two hydrogens, one sulfur and four oxygen atoms. So relative molecular mass of H2SO4 is equal to 2 into average atomic mass of hydrogen plus 1 into average atomic mass of sulfur plus 4 into average atomic mass of oxygen. So this is how we need to calculate the relative molecular mass of H2SO4. So we know that the average atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.008. 1 into 32 is the average atomic mass of sulfur plus 4 into 16 is the average atomic mass of oxygen. So by simplifying, we will get 2.016 plus 32 plus 64. So which is equal to 98.016 is the average atomic mass of H2SO4. This is how we need to calculate for each and every molecule. We need to add the average atomic mass of individual atoms in a molecule. Next, we are going to see the differences between atoms and molecules. First difference: atom is the smallest particle of an element. So first we need to know what are elements as well as what are compounds. So elements in the sense atoms of same type, compounds in the sense two or more atoms, which means two or more different types of elements will be presented in compounds. For example, carbon, chlorine, these are all some examples of elements, as well as homoatomic molecules also contain same type of elements, so they are also coming under elements only. H2O and CO2 are the some examples for compounds. So atoms in the sense single units, simplest units of any element, as well as molecules in the sense it should be having at least two or more atoms. It might be element or compound, but it should be having at least two atoms. Next difference: atoms not exist in free state as well as molecules exist in free state. So all elements except inert gases, all the other elements will not be presented in free state. So these are called inert gases: helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. Okay, so except these six elements, all other elements will not be presented in free state, because the outermost orbitals of inert gases are fulfilled with the electrons. On account of that, they will be in stable state. Other than inert gases, all other elements will be having vacant outermost orbitals. Due to that, they will be in unstable state. For example, hydrogen. So hydrogen, the atomic number of hydrogen is 1, and we cannot see any hydrogen in single atomic state, which means in free state. It will always be combined with another hydrogen, and it will be in the form of H2 only, because other than inert gases, all other elements will not be presented in free state. But in the case of molecules, for example, H2O, water. In water, already oxygen and hydrogen are combined each other to attain stable state. See, the atomic number of oxygen is 8 and the electronic configuration will be 2,6, and for hydrogen it is only 1. In the outermost orbital, maximum 8 electrons can occupy in the case of hydrogen. So in the first orbital, maximum 2 electrons can occupy. Due to that, all of those three elements will share their outermost orbitals and all of them will attain stable state. That's why molecules can exist in free state. Next difference, atoms are highly reactive whereas molecules are less reactive. As we know already, to attain the octet state, to attain the stable state, all atoms form bonds with any other atoms. For example, carbon. The atomic number of carbon is 6 and the electronic configuration of carbon will be 2,4. In the second orbital, maximum 8 electrons can occupy. Carbon needs 4 more electrons to attain the octet state. Due to that, carbon, not only carbon, all atoms are highly reactive. Except noble gases, all other atoms are highly reactive to attain the stable state. Noble gases are unreactive because they are stable in nature. Let's consider molecules. For example, CH4. In CH4, carbon is bonded with 4 different hydrogen atoms. As we know already, carbon needs 4 more electrons to attain the octet state. That's why it's forming 4 bonds with 4 hydrogen atoms. This is how molecules are less reactive, because already they are in stable state. Due to that, they will be less reactive. Next difference, atoms do not have bonds whereas molecules do have bonds. As we know already, chemical bonds are formed either by sharing of electrons or completely transfer of electron from one atom to another. This is how chemical bonds are formed. Chemical bonds are nothing but that is a type of chemical force that holds atoms together. So to form a chemical bond, at least 2 atoms are needed. So single atom cannot have any bond. Look at this example. In this picture, you could see that to form a chemical bond, at least we need 2 atoms. One atom cannot have bond. That's why we are saying that atoms do not have bonds. Next, we are going to see about mole concept. Mole is nothing but it is the amount of substance that contains as many elementary entities as there are atoms in exactly 12 grams of carbon-12 isotope. Elementary entities in the sense they might be atoms, molecules, are ions, as there are atoms in exactly 12 grams of carbon-12 isotope. Let's compare with this example. In shops, if you go and ask 5 kg of sugar, the unknown quantity of sugar will be compared with the reference 5 kg stone. Isn't it? Here, the reference sample is carbon-12 isotope. So, mole concept is almost like to count how many sugar crystals are there in 5 kg of sugar. So it is almost like counting the sugar particles in 5 kg of sugar. So in mole concept, we will count the number of atoms per chemical substance. So the number of atoms which are presented in 1 mole of any chemical substance is equal to the number of atoms which are presented in 12 grams of carbon-12 isotope. So here the reference sample is carbon-12 isotope. So this is how we need to calculate the mole of any chemical substance. And also, mole is nothing but it is the SI unit of amount of substance. SI unit of amount of chemical substance. Okay, now we are going to calculate mole for chemical substances. So 1 mole is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power 23, which means in 1 mole of any chemical substance, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms or molecules will be presented. So for example, in 1 kg, 1000 grams are there. Like that, in 1 mole, 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 atoms or molecules will be presented. For example, 1 mole of water contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of H2O, as well as 1 mole of sulfuric acid. 1 mole of H2SO4 contains 6.023 into 10 to the power molecules of H2SO4. So 1 mole of any substance contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 of elementary entities, and this number is called as Avogadro number, and Avogadro number has no unit. Okay, so 1 mole of any substance contains 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 of atoms or molecules. To calculate the number of molecules which are presented in 5 moles of water, we need to multiply the Avogadro number by 5, which means 5 moles of water contains 5 into 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of water in it. As well as to calculate 6 moles of water, then Avogadro number should be multiplied by 6. This is how we need to calculate mole for every substance. Now we are going to calculate the number of moles for atoms as well as molecules. Number of moles is always denoted by the symbol small n. Okay, first we are going to see how to calculate the number of moles for atoms. So n is equal to mass divided by average atomic mass. For molecules, it is equal to mass divided by average molecular mass or relative molecular mass. Both are same only, average molecular mass. Okay, let's see with an example. First for atoms. So we need to find the number of moles of sodium which is presented in 24 grams. So n is equal to mass divided by average atomic mass. Here 24 gram is mass and the average atomic mass of sodium is 23, which is equal to 1.043. So 1.043 moles of sodium is presented in 24 grams. As well as for molecules. Now we are going to find the number of moles in 24 grams of H2SO4. As it is a molecule, first we need to find out the average molecular mass. So what are the elements are presented in H2SO4? Hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen. There are 2 hydrogens, 1 sulfur and 4 oxygens. So the average molecular mass is equal to 2 into 1 plus 1 into 32 plus 4 into 16. The average atomic mass should be multiplied with the number of elements, so which is equal to 2 plus 32 plus 64. So altogether, which is equal to 98. So 98 is the average molecular mass of H2SO4. Now we are going to substitute these values in number of moles formula. So n is equal to 24 divided by 98, which is equal to 0.244 moles. So 24 grams of H2SO4 contains 0.244 moles of H2SO4 molecules. This is how we need to find out the number of moles for atoms as well as for molecules. For molecules, first we need to find out the average molecular mass. After that, we need to substitute the values in the formula. The number of moles of atoms and molecules can be calculated by dividing the mass by average atomic mass or average molecular mass for atoms and molecules respectively. But for gases, we need to use another method. So the unknown quantity of gases will be compared with molar volume. So molar volume is nothing but at stand at temperature and pressure. So usually the standard temperature and pressure is abbreviated to STP. So STP is the abbreviation of standard temperature and pressure. The value of standard temperature is 273.15 Kelvin, as well as the standard pressure. The value of standard pressure is 1 atmospheric pressure. So the value of STP is 273.15 Kelvin and 1 atmospheric pressure. At standard temperature and pressure, the volume of any gas occupies 22.4 liters. 1 mole of any gas at standard temperature and pressure occupies 22.4 liters. So this is what molar volume. So in 1 mole of molecules or atoms contain 6.023 × 10²³ of elementary entities, whereas the number of moles of gas is equal to volume divided by molar volume. So molar volume is nothing but it is equal to 22.4 liters. Okay, let's see with an example. Now we are going to find out the number of moles of carbon dioxide which is presented in 2 liters at standard temperature and pressure. So here volume is 2 liters, that should be divided by 22.4, which is the value of molar volume. So 22.4 liters. By dividing, we will get 0.089. So in 2 liters of carbon dioxide, 0.089 moles of carbon dioxide molecules are presented. This is how we need to find out the number of moles for gases at standard temperature and pressure. Next, we are going to see percentage composition. So percent composition is the mass of each element present in 100 grams of compound. Example, in 24 grams of H2O, we don't know how much quantity of hydrogen and how much quantity of oxygen are presented. So to find out the mass of each element which is presented in a molecule, we are using percent composition. So percent composition is equal to mass of each element which is presented in that compound divided by molecular mass molecular mass of that compound, and that should be multiplied by 100 because we are finding out the percentage composition, so that should be multiplied by 100. This is the formula which we are using to find out percentage composition of each element which is presented in any compound. First, we are going to find out the percentage composition of H2SO4. In H2SO4, hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen are presented, and there are 2 hydrogen, 1 sulfur and 4 oxygen atoms are presented. We have already found out the molecular mass of H2SO4, that is equal to 98. So straight away I am going to find out the percentage composition of hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen which are presented in. So the mass of hydrogen is 1 and there are 2 hydrogen atoms. So 2 into 1 divided by the molecular mass of H2SO4 is 98 into 100, because we are going to find out the percentage. Due to that we should multiply with 100. So as plus for sulfur, there is only 1 sulfur, so 1 into 32 divided by 98 into 100. As well as there are 4 oxygen atoms, so 4 into 16 divided by 98 into 100. So the percentage of hydrogen is 2.04 presented in H2SO4. As well as for sulfur, okay, 32.65% of sulfur is presented. As well as next oxygen, 65.03% of oxygen is presented in H2SO4. So to cross verify whether we have done correctly or not, we need to add all these three values. By adding, we should get 100, or the value should be closer to 100. So by adding all these values, we will get 99.99, which is almost closer to 100. So we have done correctly. So this is how we need to find out the percentage composition of each and every element which are presented in any compounds. Thank you for watching. We'll see in the next video. Thank you.